Welcome to Inspire Thinking. Once again, I'm back with the book synopsis, How to Win Friends and Influence People by Dale Carnegie. We have completed two parts from this book, and we are in part three. And today we are talking about 11th chapter. And 11th chapter name is A Sure Way of Making Enemies and How to Avoid It. A Sure Way of Making Enemies and How to Avoid It. Yes. Dale Carnegie says, never ever start your conversation with, I can prove this, I can prove that, I can do this, I can do that, I can do anything in this world. Do not start your conversation and don't announce these kind of things, because this is wrong. So when you say this, the opposition party will get aroused and they think, okay, he will really prove. I will see how he would prove it. And he starts battling with you before you start your presentation or your conversation only. So that's why 300 years ago, Galileo says, we cannot teach anyone anything. You cannot teach anyone anything, but you can only help them to find out within themselves. You can only make them think, but you cannot teach anything to anyone. That's why Socrates used to tell to their followers is only one thing. I know only one thing, that is nothing. I know only one thing, that is nothing. Yes. Dale Carnegie, as usual, given many examples in this chapter. And one of the best example, I would say, one of his friend used to work in automobiles company in customer service. He used to sit on billing part. He used to handle different customer queries daily. And he used to go mad by handling these kind of queries, because customers used to come him and bang him, scold him, and lot many things happens in customer service, right? And at lastly, this fellow has decided, oh my God, this is not working for me. If somebody comes to me and banging on me and my company, I'm banging them. This is not the way. And I'm spoiling my career, isn't it? Yes. And he decided, he came to a conclusion that I need to talk to the customer in this way only. Whenever customer used to come to them, he used to tell, my dealership men did many mistakes. My team has did many mistakes. I'm really afraid of it. And in fact, in your case also, we are mistaken. Please tell me how can help you. And this approach has changed his entire career. People used to talk with him because he used to be a crystal clear clarity what problems or what not. And this has changed entire perception in this marketing part, especially automobile company billing customer service. Coming to Dale Carnegie, Dale Carnegie has employed a person for his interior decoration. And entire decoration happened. He got a bill. By looking this bill, Dale Carnegie dismayed. He shocked to see such an expensive bill. But everything was happened. He has to pay the bill. No other option. And he paid the bill. The next day, one of his friend came to his house and looked at these draperies, curtains and interior decoration, and asked Dale, what a beautiful curtains and all these things you have. What is it cost? And the expensive cost has been explained by Dale Carnegie to his friend. And his friend said, oh my God, this is awful. How much cost is it? Really? Oh my God, he has to put a curtain on you as well. And Dale Carnegie, as a human tendency, what do we do? Dale Carnegie says, this is costly curtains, this is costly designs and all these things. And he started telling this part. And his friend replied, okay, I know this in this market, we will get same draperies for less cost only, but you have spent a lot. And he left from there. Immediate next day, one more friend dropped into his house and asked, oh my God, what a beautiful draperies. And Dale Carnegie told the expenditure of that draperies and the curtains of interior design. And that fellow replied Dale Carnegie, oh my God, I wish I could have bear this much of exterior, interior designs for my home. Such an expensive and beautiful draperies. I wish I could have in my home. And suddenly Dale Carnegie, this is another human tendency came out of Dale Carnegie. That is, Dale Carnegie started, I'm sorry for this order. I have spent lot of expenditure on this order, whereas I can get with less price outside. But unfortunately, I have employed a person where he charged more. See, the first fellow told the truth to the Dale Carnegie, but he is not ready to accept it. The second person told in a different way, but Dale Carnegie has revealed the secret, isn't it? Yes, people are not ready to listen the truth unless and until it would be handled tactfully or diligently. If you handle tactfully, automatically the truth will come out. Basically, what we do is, we know what we do mistakes in our life, but we don't tell to others. If someone handles carefully or tactfully with us, we can tell them our mistakes to them as well, isn't it? Yes, that is why the principle of this chapter is show respect to the other person's opinion. Never say you are wrong. Show respect to the other person's opinion. Never say you are wrong. This is all about this chapter. A sure way of making enemies and how to avoid it. Until then, Lakshmikant, signing out. We will meet again. Stay tuned.